In this video, we'll explain how to connect to a database in a KNIME workflow. To connect to a database, we need a connector node that creates the connection to the database via its JDBC driver. The KNIME database extension provides a set of nodes for connecting to all JDBC compliant databases. The nodes are a part of KNIME Analytics Platform installation, so no additional installation is necessary. Many file-based and server-based databases, such as SQLite and MySQL, have dedicated connector nodes. These connector nodes already contain the necessary JDBC drivers and provide configuration options that are tailored to the specific database. Dedicated connector nodes for big data platforms, such as Apache Hive or Impala, can be obtained by installing the KNIME Big Data extension, which is also open source. If no dedicated connector node exists for your database, you can use the generic DB connector node. Let's have a look at an example workflow where we connect to a database. Here, we want to read data from a MySQL database, so we can use the MySQL connector node. In the configuration dialog of the MySQL connector node, in this first drop-down menu here, we can change the database dialect. In the second drop-down menu, we can change the JDBC driver. Here below, we define the host name and port where the database resides. Next, we enter the name of the database that we want to access. In the authentication section, we provide the credentials to access this database. One option is to provide the username and password here in this field. However, since entering and storing a username and password directly in the dialog might lead to security issues, KNIME allows you to provide credentials from outside the node via a flow variable connection coming from the credentials configuration node. The available credentials are shown in this menu. The other tabs are for advanced optional settings. In the JDBC Parameters tab, we can add custom JDBC driver connection parameters. In the Advanced tab, we configure some more settings, such as the query for validating the connection. In the Input Type Mapping and Output Type Mapping tabs, we can define which data types in KNIME Analytics Platform correspond to the data types associated with our database. However, the settings that we already defined in the Connection Settings tabs are often enough to establish the connection. So we click OK. We can now access the MySQL database. The output of the node shows some information about the connection that we just created. Notice that the connection between the dedicated connector node and the JDBC driver does not exist automatically for MS SQL Server and Amazon Redshift databases due to licensing restrictions. Their JDBC drivers have to be installed separately as KNIME extensions. After that, the dedicated connector node will automatically connect to the appropriate JDBC driver and provide it in the configuration dialog. For databases that don't have dedicated connector nodes, we can use the generic DB connector node, which can connect to arbitrary JDBC compliant databases. In such a case, it's necessary to register the corresponding JDBC driver in KNIME Analytics Platform. Let's say we want to connect to a SAP HANA database that doesn't have a dedicated connector node. We can register its JDBC driver in the dialog that opens if we go to File, Preferences, KNIME, Databases. We click Add, and in the dialog that opens, we provide a unique ID and name of the JDBC driver. In this menu on the right, we define the database type, which is SAP HANA in our case. Our database type is not listed in the menu, so we select the default option. In this field below, we specify the URL template. We can click this question mark to see the available options for creating the URL template. Finally, we provide the path to the JDBC driver in our system. The driver can be downloaded from the website of the database provider. We click OK, and as you can see, the newly added driver appears in the list. Now, let's open the configuration dialog of the DB connector node. It looks much the same as the configuration dialog of the MySQL connector node. We select the newly registered SAP HANA driver here in the driver name menu. There are other settings we define as well, just as when we connected to the MySQL database. Thus, the connection to the SAP HANA database has been created successfully. Now that we are connected to a database, we could use the DB table selector node to select a table in the database and continue with many in-database manipulation operations using other DB nodes. At any point, we could also import the data back into KNIME using the DB reader node. In this video, we've explained how to connect to a database using KNIME DB nodes. We've shown how to connect to a database via its dedicated connector node, and how to connect to any JDBC compliant database in general via the DB connector node. We've also explained how to register a new JDBC driver into KNIME Analytics Platform.